Friends, welcome back to my channel. In this session we will discuss what is the resolver and how we can test it. Basically, it is an email from my viewer. I watch your some of videos and I appreciate your work. I was wondering if you have any oscilloscope video that demonstrates how a resolver output can shift from low value to high value and almost instantly due to an electrical fault like an electrical short, power quality issue, EMI, etc. For example, going from 0 degree to 75 degree in 3 or 4 seconds. Any assistant would be appreciated. First, we will take a very short brief for resolver. We have a transformer here. And it have a core, it have output. We apply some signal in the input and it will provide output. If the winding is in phase, it will provide in phase signal. So we will receive like this, or we will receive signal like this here. Otherwise, if we have opposite winding at that time, it will provide opposite signal. This or this signal, it will depend on the winding. If the winding will shift, secondary winding will shift its position, in this condition the maximum mutual induction will occur and we will take output voltage. If our winding will come in this condition, the induction level will change, and if we will rotate this winding, the signal value will opposite 180 degree. As we discussed here, if the winding is in phase, we have this signal. If we have out of phase, we have this signal with respect to this reference signal. This is one condition. If you have two windings, one winding like this and second winding like this, rotor winding, so its output will directly proportional to the mechanical shaft position of the rotor winding, secondary winding. As we see in synchro transmitters, we apply a signal and we take 120 degree out of phase signals due to the winding locations. We will take three phase signals. But in resolver, there is very small difference between the synchro transmitter and a rotary transformer. That's the resolver. Resolver have one excitation winding and it have two output windings, one winding and second winding. Both windings are at 90 degree. It will depend on the type of the resolver. If you are using 90 degree resolver, it will provide sine and cosine degree. Some resolvers are 180 degree resolvers. One winding, the second winding, these are opposite to each other. It will provide 180 degree opposite output to each other. If you will use this high and this high, that time the output signal will in phase. We will see practically. If we have single phase resolver, its output will in phase or out of phase with reference to input. And if we have two inputs, two phase resolver, for example, this is 0 degree and here we have 90 degree signal. When this signal is high, the second signal will high at this point. At that time, the resultant magnetic field, that is excitation signal, at that time the resultant magnetic field, that will in result of two magnetic fields, 0 degree and 90 degree, we will take output from these windings. This time I have 180 degree out of phase signals, this resolver, 9A70L-108, this resolver, it is most commonly it is used to transduce the positions, mechanical shaft position. This collar, it is connected to the stationary part, and this rotor is connected to the moving part, so that this part is stationary and this part is moving. Its stator is connected with stationary item and its rotor will move with moving part, so it will provide output voltage with respect to the mechanical shaft position. And the resultant magnetic field, if our this magnetic field is here and this magnetic field is here, so resultant magnetic field will here. With this magnetic field we will receive output voltage, and these voltage will be compared for the next circuit to phase sensitive detectors to detect the position, detect the angle. It have stator winding. Now we will make the good position. S1, S3 for one winding, S2, S4, these two windings for the stator. Similarly, we have rotor windings, R1, R3, R2, R4. The solid colors here, these are stator pins, and the barbed colors are rotor colors. You need to translate, you need to check the wire color, decode wire colors depending on your resolver. It need 26 volt. Some resolvers use 400 hertz, and this is using 900 hertz. It is a very basic item in industrial automation, industrial machineries. If you want to apply two signals 90 degree apart or 120 degree apart, you can use, but this time I will use one signal. I will excite one winding and we will take output from these two windings. The other remaining winding connections we will make ground. It is the best practice to ground it. I will apply test signal here, that is 11.8 volt sine wave signal, 900 hertz, and I will place this paper tape here. These two stator windings and this return wire for the first winding, I will ground it. And I will connect a signal here to the red wire. Now I have two output windings. The red one is high signal, red white, and black white is low signal for the first rotor winding. Red white is high, it is in my case. In your case you need to translate your resolver's position. Blue white and yellow white, blue white and yellow white. I connected channel A to one winding, one rotor winding, and channel B to the second rotor winding. Now we can see I am taking two outputs. When I will change the shaft position, one voltage level will increase, the second will decrease. And we will bring one position that both signals are in phase. We will mark this position. This time both signals are in phase. We can say this is our 0 degree, assume that. 0 degree, A and B are in phase, both signals are in phase. I will move it 45 degree clockwise. Can say here is at 45 degree amplitude of one cycle is increased. Now one cycle increased, the second is, this is A, this is B. Here A is equal to B. Now we will move to 90 degree. At 90 degree, the first phase this way, the channel B is now opposite, 180 degree out of phase signal. 135 degree. Now we can see the first signal is now zero, the first signal at 135 degree, and the second signal is now opposite. When we will move it at 180 degree, both signals are again in line. This is test condition for one resolver. Now we will move again. Now the same repetition will come. At each position, voltage and phase level will change. In phase or out of phase. It will move opposite. Its voltage condition will change. So the next controller, phase sensitive detector, will measure these amplitudes and it will check the phase. What is the phase angle? What is the voltage value of first channel, the second channel? At that time, it will check the degree. In this way, it can measure the shaft position. Now this is a good resolver. Now we can check the shaft position using XY function. Set your oscilloscope to 10x. Here is also 10x. And now go to display. In the display, here is XY. Use XY function. And now rotate the shaft. You will see the shaft rotation, and it must be smooth without any distortion. This is a good resolver condition. Rotate clockwise, anticlockwise. And if you see here, all the signals are moving smoothly. There is no distortion at all. So this is a good resolver. And we can also excite the second winding. We will apply one signal to one winding, and the second end we will connect to ground. And the first stator S1, S3, we will ground it together. First we applied excitation to one winding, now to the second winding. In both conditions, it will work in this way. So this is a good resolver. Now I will use a failed resolver which I removed from the machine. It must be pure sine signal because it is a linear device. I will apply excitation signal to one winding. The same way, we will connect ground to other three wires. The same way, I will connect channel A, high side to red-white, low signal to black-white. These colors are in my condition. Blue-white. If you will change the wire colors here, the signal phase will differ automatically. Now I have this resolver. We can see its signal is distorted. So this distorted signal is not allowed in this technology. We can see this time both signals are grounded, both signals are lowered. This signal must be smooth without any distortion, you can see. This distorted signal, it will not allow the machine to run properly because it will not give a good value. This condition is not allowed. Okay, in some conditions you can remove this screw, and there are slip rings, brushes. These are very soft, just only spray some contact cleaner. It will some time work for 1 week, 1 month, 6 months, but it have to damage. So it is the best practice to replace it. It is for the best servicing for the machine. If you are working with very heavy equipment, it is impossible to open all the time every week for servicing. So just only we can see this is the condition. If I will select the XY, now we can see its output is not proper. It must be bar. We can see here is dot. Now it's collapsed here. It must be smooth bar like this, and it must rotate with respect to this shaft position. Sometime it is coming as a ring, as an inductor. So this sign is no good. In this way you can test the resolver. Especially when you are testing resolver, you need oscilloscope. You need function generator or signal generator, sine wave. Pure sine wave is good. And you can also use angle position indicator that will measure the four signals R1, R2, R3. That is most commonly used NA, North Atlantic, 8810. It is very known device for the resolvers. There are many angle position indicators are available, analog and mechanical, but this one is digital and that is perfect. We can see this one is not good resolver. So that was the reason I removed it, and I mentioned here that it is failed because it is not providing a good result. I hope so you enjoyed this video. If you enjoyed it, hit the like button. If you have any question, write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.